Hello dears, next part is finding quantity. When you study this part, you are studying some things as new, okay? This chapter is full of new things, isn't it? So don't make a confusion with any topics. You can watch the video many times, then you get the time. And you have to understand the concept very well, okay? That is very, very important, okay? Any doubts you can ask, okay? So finding quantity, how can we find a quantity? I just write example. After writing the example, I will introduce a new thing to you, okay? So one question is that, find the 20% of 50, okay? Find 20% of 50. We have to find out the 20% of 50. 20% of 50. Something it is given as 20%. Percentage if it is given. To find out that one, 20% of 50, what you have to do? 20% means just write 20 by 100 of what? 50. 20 by 100 into 50. So anything that you are given as something that is find it dash percentage of dash number means if it is given as percentage, you can simply write 20 that number by 100. That is the percentage of it. Okay, of what it is 50, then you have to do the usual thing. 150, you can complete, you can cut this one. Now 5 and 10, 1 5 are 5, 2 5 are 10, 20 by 2, what is the answer? 20 divided by 2 is 10. So what is 20% of 50? What is the answer? 10. Okay, so this is very simple. 20% it is given us, very simple. One thing, whatever the things it is given, this is okay, but one more thing. That means 30% of 80. One more example, like 30% of 80. Then what you have to do? 30 by 100 into 80. Then cut it. Cut it. Okay. Then 8 and 10, we can. This 0, we can cut. Is it 30, 10 is there? 10, 10 is there. This is both are in. This 30 and 80 both are in numerator and 10 only in the denominator. 0, 0 we already cut. This 0 we can cut easily. Then only 1 remain. So 3 into 8 is 24. 24 by 1 is what? 24. So what is the answer? 24. So this is okay. This is very simple. 30% is something given us, just divide by 100. So now let me ask you if you have a question. Okay, example. 4 by 5 percentage of 500. 4 by 5 percentage of 500. Okay. 4 by 5. This is a fraction. So what I told you, whatever the percentage you ask, you have to write it. It does like this way. 4 by 5 by 100, isn't it? 30% of how you wrote it? 30 by 100. But here, what it is? 4 by 5 divided by 100. So this is the new thing. This is a new thing for you. Before I am going to write this, do this question, I will explain one thing that is called as just study these things. You are studying this as new, but the upcoming years, this is what a usual thing for you. Understand? Every day you have to do this kind of things. Very important thing also, reciprocal multiplication. Okay, it is not a given in the textbook as a like this heading, but the operation is there. That means reciprocal multiplication they are using there, but did not give any explanation about this one. I am just explaining to you, okay? What is reciprocal multiplication? So any numbers, for example, I am taking the same number for now, 1 by 2 divided by 100. This kind of things comes means you can say that this is 1 by 2 form, this is also by form. Okay, 1 divided by 2 divided by 100. So just assume that this 100 is what? Simply it is 100, isn't it? 100 by 1 is what? 100, isn't it? 100 by 1 is also what? 100. 100 by 1 is also what? 100. So why I am explaining this one? Because to do this calculation, we have to multiply, not divide. That's why I am explaining. How we are multiplying, it is depends upon this thing. So 100 is divided by 100. 1 by 2, the whole divided by 100. This number whole divided by 100, isn't it? So this 100 we can again write as what? 100 by 1. 100 by 1 and 100 is same. Is it the same? It's same, isn't it? So for our convenience, I am writing 100 as what? 100 by 1. whatever the number it is there, for this calculation we have to imagine that one is there. Okay, 100 by 1 is 100. Okay, so 1 by 2 divided by 100 by 1, just right. Okay, then what is next step is keep this number like this way, 1 by 2. Okay, that numerator part, this is actually numerator and this is denominator. 1 by 2 is actually the numerator. This whole number is what a numerator part, and this part is what a denominator. 1 by 2 just keep there, and this one we have to take the reciprocal. Reciprocal means this is 100 by 1. Okay, reciprocal of a number means this is 100 by 1. Reciprocal of it is 1 by 100. Understand what is reciprocal? That's the reverse of it. Okay, then what is the reciprocal of 3 by 4? It is 4 by 3. Okay, understand? So you have to take the reciprocal of that number, 100 by 1. Just like the reciprocal, what you will get? 1 by 100. And multiply it. Understand? Take the reciprocal of this number and multiply with the first number. Understand? That is called reciprocal multiplication. Okay. So, what was our question? When we are writing the question, then I will say 4 by 5 percentage of 500 is the question. So, I wrote 4 by 5 divided by 100. Okay. Into 500, we have to do it. Okay. Isn't it? We have to do it. Okay. So, here what we have to do it is, this is equal to 4 by 5. This is 100 by 1. Isn't it 100 by 1? Take the reciprocal and multiply it. Reciprocal is what? 1 by 100. Multiply it. And 1 500 is there. Isn't it? That is how to write into 500. Understand? 4 by 5 into 1 by 100 into 500. Okay. So, next part is what? Just cut the numerators and the denominators. You can cut here two zeros with easily. Two zeros gone. Then 5 and this 5 is there. Then 5. Okay. This 5 is gone, this 5 is gone. Then what is the answer? 4. Understand? 4 is our answer. Okay. 4 is the answer. Okay. So this is the reciprocal multiplication. Okay. Okay, now one more. Okay, 3 by 4 of 20. 3 by 4 of 20. 20. Okay, so what we have to do? 3 by 4 divided by 3 by 5 percentage. Okay, 3 by 4 percentage. That's why we are writing by 100. Okay, just write 100 by 1. Because this is actually what? This is a whole number, means no problem to us because this is a fraction. Okay, 3 by 4 of 100. I want into 20 we have to do. Okay, 3 by 4 of 100 into 20 it is that. Okay, 3 by 4 of 100 into 3 by 4 4 by 100 into 20 it is that. But for this, to do this one we have to, but reciprocal multiplication we have to do. Okay, so I write this way. Now this one becomes 3 by 4. That's not, this one I have no problem keeping there. This denominator 100 by 1 become what? 1 by 100. That is only the thing. 1 by 100 by 1. 100 by 1 become 1 by 100. Into what? 20. It is only numerator part. Okay. Now, we can cut the numbers. Isn't it? Here, we can cut in many ways. Okay. 0, 0 and we can cut. Now, 10 and 2. Okay. 10 and 2 when you cut means, what will you get? Here, 10. This 2 means 1, 2 are 2. Isn't it? So here 5, okay, 5 twos are 10. Now we will get an answer like this way. This is 3 in 3 by 20 we got. Okay, this is, we can simplify and find the answer 3 by 20 because I just put a number here. Okay, so we don't get an exact answer here. 3 by 20 we will get it. So this is the answer. Okay, yes. So this is the answer for this question. Like that, we have to understand what is happening on here. Okay, you won't get the answer like this way. We will have a correct answer for every question. So what is the operation is happening? What is happening here? This denominator part become what? A reciprocal of it. Okay. So this is called a reciprocal multiplication. One question is on your textbook. 1 by 2 of 100. 1 by 2 of 100 meter, whatever it is, meter and centimeter, whatever it is, not a matter. We have to do first, this is what a mixed fraction is, so we have to convert into the proper fraction. So what we have to do? 1 into 2, 2 plus 1, 3 by 2. Okay, then
3 by 2. Again, our heading is not over. 3 by 2 it is there. Again, this is what a fraction. 3 by 2. 1 by 1 by 2 percentage, we are first converting to proper fraction. 3 by 2 we will go to 3 by 2 by 100. Okay. 1 into 2, 2. 2 plus 1, 3. Okay, this is the, that I hope that all of you remember. 1 into 2 plus 1. Converting itself fraction into improper. 1 into 2, 2. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 we are writing and divisor. Okay. 3 by 2. 3 by 2 by 100 into what? 100. Okay. 3 by 2. 3 by 2 we have to write there. This 100 become 1 by 100 into 100. Okay. And these things we can cut. Okay. 0 and the 0 will cause. Then what is the our answer? 3 by 2. Is our answer. Okay. Yes, 3 by 2 we will call 3 by 2 meter. So usually this length will be write as what a simplified form. That is 3 by 2 is what a 3 divided by 2 is 1 by 1.5. This is 3 by 2. Okay. 1 2 is 2. 3 minus 2, 1 we will get a. Okay. 1 we will get a. We have to put a point, then 10. 5 2 is 10. Okay. So we will get a 1.5 meter. Okay. So this is the right answer. So this is actually 100 meter they asked, that's why we found out the exact answer. Okay. So this is the method. So I hope that you understand how we are finding a quantity. Okay, something percentage is given as, percentage means what? Divide by 100. 5% means 5 by 100. 5% of 25. If it is given as 5 by 100, you can simply write whatever it is. If it, rather it is a fraction, whatever it is, percentage means just divide by 100 into that number. 5 by 100 into 25. Then cut it. You will get a here 5 by 4. Isn't it? Yes. Then 5 by 4 is 5 by 4. You have to find it. 5 by 4, what is the answer? You will get it. You have to find 1 point something. You will get it. So that is the answer for that thing. Okay. So this is the way we are finding the quantity. Okay. One question in the textbook. You are having a question. That means a school find that 20% of students usually excels in sports. School find that 20% of students usually excels in sports. 20% of the total students excels in sports. There are 200 students in a school. Okay, in that school 200 students are there. Okay, out of these 200 students, 20% students are excel in sports. Okay, so what is the number of students there? How many students are excels in sports? They are asking the number. Total number of students is 200. 200 students are there. Total 200 students are there. Out of this 200 students, 20% is excels. Only 20% is excels. But we don't know exactly how many students are there. Number of students. Okay. This is percentage. So we have to find out how many students are excels in sports. So 20% excels in out. Okay. 20% of students are excels in sports out of 200 students. So how many students? How can we find 20% means 20 by 100 into 200. Okay, then 0 cut, 20 into 2, 40. So 40 students, understand? It means that what? 20% of 200 is what? 40. Got it? So 40 students are excels in sports. So what, something it is asking you to find out the percentage of something means that percentage divided by 100 into that number is the answer. Okay, so this is the way finding the quantity. When you are doing the more exercise, you will get the more clarification, and we can correct or but doubts also. Okay, if you any finding any difficulty when you are doing the exercise, we can you have to clear it. Okay, don't keep it hide, because you are studying. If you are doubts, you have to clear it up to date. Okay, day by day, if you are finding many mistakes and you are keeping it, it will be just like a butter big headache when you are writing exam. Okay, so keep that in mind. Thank you.